I'm Ian Thomas, editor of Front Office Sports. I'm here with Riley Mahoney, senior category manager at Adidas. Riley, thanks for joining me.
Yeah, thanks for having me, Ian.
Exciting moment here with this 25th season for MLS. Obviously, Adidas being one of the biggest partners for the league. Walk me through a little bit what the approach to the jerseys were this coming season.
Yeah, so, I mean, really this journey started back in 2018. It's a two-year process to get these jerseys to market. And as we looked at the 25th celebration of the league, we went deep into our archives and pulled out the EQT design jerseys. EQT was instrumental for football, for soccer in the early 90s. When you think about it being on the back of the US men's national team in 92, we knew that this was the design we wanted to go with. So you see a league-wide EQT striping, an extended collar, the 90s are in, retro is in, and it really helps authenticate that 25th celebration story and really brings it from authenticity to progression and making sure we're celebrating that with the league fully.
What is the design process like with the teams and the clubs and the league office itself?
Yeah, I'm glad you asked. It's a huge collaboration between the clubs, between the leagues, between our team in Germany, as well as locally. We have six designers that sit in Herzo at our headquarters. These designers work on Manchester United, on Arsenal, on Real Madrid, on all of our federations, and they also support us on the league. So the same designer who did the Atlanta United kit also did the Real Madrid kit that just launched. It starts with the clubs. They have the opportunity to give us a brief with mood boards, with what they want to come to life, with what they want the jersey to really look and feel like. That goes through the Adidas lens for our creation for the season. For 2020, it was all about the unification of art and football. So you'll see a lot of hand-drawn brushstroke graphics making that beautiful game, the beautiful jersey come to life. We then present a couple options back to the club. They get an opportunity to provide feedback. And then we start getting into the sample rounds. We'll start tweaking things a little bit. You think about a league of 26 teams in 24 different cities. We want to make sure that every jersey is unique and every jersey is a true reflection of the city, of the fan base, and of course of the club.
What are you seeing right now in terms of the growth of products for MLS? League obviously continues to grow, popularity continues to grow. How does that kind of reflect in terms of the relationship that Adidas has with league?
I mean, we've been the sole supplier of the kit since 2005. We just signed a new extension through 2024. So it's a partnership we massively believe in and something we're super excited about when you think about the opportunity to shape what soccer looks like, not just in the US, but all of North America, and then taking that down to the kids, to the academies, and then expanding the game globally and making sure that whether you're in Latin America or in Western Europe, you understand the importance of the league and the quality on the field, but also in the product we bring to life. So all of our jerseys are one-to-one match with what you see from the rest of the federations. It features our aero-ready technology. Our authentic jersey is 98% recycled polyester. So it's bringing that best performance fabric to the players. And then we get that one-to-one match to the consumer when you talk about our authentic jersey.
So you have this really interesting seat where you can really see the growth of soccer through your position. What are you seeing right now in terms of the sport, globally, locally? How is just connecting with people in that respect?
Yeah, totally. I talked a little bit about the expansion of the game and the league. You think about, you know, what football means. I think we all grew up playing tiny tots or little kickers. It's really the sport that we're all introduced to first. And, you know, I consider myself to be one of the luckiest men alive to have the opportunity to sit and help shape the future of soccer. And, you know, the league is starting to invest in huge facilities and also investing in academies, world-class facilities, world-class coaches that can come in and help shape the future of soccer. Yes, we have signings like Chicharito, Zlatan came over, but the future generation is really 14, 16, 18. They're gonna be the ones that lead us into the 2026 World Cup and start to represent the country and become the feeders. So that's just as important to us, making sure, and if you look at our partnership with the league, we invest just as heavily in those grassroots initiatives because that's really where the heart of soccer lives.
So we're surrounded by a bunch of the jerseys for the 25th season right here. Let's walk through some of the features. Show me some of the cool things.
Yeah, let's do it. So start off, this is the DC United primary jersey. You think back to 1996, Eddie Pope scoring the game-winning goal in extra time of the inaugural MLS Cup. This jersey is a heritage kit, traditional, that ties back to that with the big EQT striping here on the shoulder. You have a raised rubber execution on DC United on the back neck, and on the jock tag, you have Unite the District. These are customizable pieces that each club can do. You have an authentic DC United heat-applied crest and the four stars celebrating their championship. A really cool feature for all of our inaugural 9 teams, you can see a founded in the club logo for one of the founding inaugural clubs. So the 9 founding clubs that are still in the league will feature that mark, a little surprise and delight on the inside of the jock tag. We talk about the art in football. This jersey ties back again to that 96 inaugural kit with the color block. Again, hand-drawn brushstroke graphics from our design team, really bringing that art of football to life. And then we start to get more progressive when we think about making sure we authenticate in the streets. Here you have a loon graphic tying back to the heritage of the club. Even though they're only in their 3rd season, Minnesota United has a heritage of soccer and their fans have been asking for a jersey. So you see a debossed wing logo coming to life there. For Philadelphia Union, we put an embossed snake on the jersey. We talk about being a progressive league. No other team, no other league in the world would do that kind of execution. You see that snake, that scaling effect of the snake coming to life. And last but certainly not least, LAFC, the trendiest club in MLS with an all black execution. They even went tonal on their stripes. You can see the YouTube logo coming to life in a gold accent. Shoulder to shoulder called out on the inside neck tape. A club that's built alongside 3252, their supporters group, making sure that in every step they do, they have their community and their supporters group in mind, their consumers. And these are just the differences that we do that our great team in Herzo does to make sure that every jersey is so unique and so authentic to that home city and to that home consumer.
You see all these super really unique areas on the jerseys. I mean, I'm sure that's where the clubs really lean in and share some of the things that make them, you know, different among MLS.
Yeah, it's so important that every jersey is unique, that every jersey is authentic to the home city, to the home fan base. And we utilize jock tags, inside neck tapes, back necks, and then of course the design of the jersey, making sure that yes, the jersey is a canvas, but that really they can create whatever art they want to really be a reflection of the club.